Satan is happy. What the reform is going to do with your money? Marry men with men, marry Jews with goyim, break more Shabbatot, turn them into Christians, like this Goldberg now, second round. He brings another Christian missionary now. First time was not enough. Now he brings another pastor to speak in his shul, and they still call that synagogue Orthodox, these fools. Now I have to step inside. Step inside, and I have to step. Reshaim al pitcha shel geinom enam shavim betshuva. They see the hell is waiting for them, and they're still stubborn. They won't surrender. After all what happened, the noise and everything, what happened? He does it again. Coming up now, he brings Christian to speak in his shul, if you can call it a shul. Unfortunately, I made that list of all the forbidden speakers. As you can see, not one of them still did tshuva, not one. If any, they get worse. Some of them, Baruch Hashem, became quiet. We don't hear from them anymore. Baruch Hashem, when they stay like this forever, mute. But some of them still make a horrible damage. Horrible damage. And this is a person who convert goyim. I don't know if one of them is Jewish, Bechla. I'll be very surprised if Hashem will accept one of his conversions. One. All the goyim that converted by him should go into a kosher bedin and get conversion again. You don't want to waste your entire life keeping mitzvot, and in the end you find out that the one who converted you is more goy than you. Use your common sense. People that promote Christianity, idol worshipping inside the synagogue, they can convert other people to Judaism? Do you think Hashem will accept such thing? Use your head, not politics. Use your common sense. Someone who preach for Christianity, bring pastor, bring missionaries to talk to his community. Maybe he can convert you to Christian, for sure. But to convert you from a Christian to a Jew, I doubt that very much. I doubt that very much. Rabotai, we have to be on alert. We have to open up our eyes. Not everything that looks religious is religious. Not everyone who looks righteous is righteous. Think 1,000 times before you give money to where you give. Some places you give money, you will be punished for it. Shoes that people talk there, women come not modest. The rabbi over there never speak the truth, he's only politically correct, kissing up to the wicked. Don't invest a penny over there. Don't pay for all kinds of parties that they're going to bring, Hanukkah parties, Purim parties, boys, girls, mixture, hundreds of sins over there. Why would you like to sponsor such thing? Places that worship some dead rabbi or other places, stay away from them. Stay away from them. You be very careful not to promote idol worshipping in any form and shape. And Bezrat Hashem, if you will really dedicate your efforts to do the right thing, to follow the right speakers, to follow the right Orthodox kosher books and rabbis, then Hashem will help you. Bederech she'adam rotzeh lilech molichim oto. You first commit, I want to follow only the truth, not politics and not really the truth. Whether it's popular, whether it's not popular, it's not relevant. I want to do the right in the eyes of Hashem. Ve'asita ha'yashar ve'atov be'enei Hashem. Ve'asita ha'yashar ve'atov. And you do what's straight and good in the eyes of your God, not in the eyes of the clowns around you, in the eyes of the university rotten speakers, in the eyes of the reforms and conservative and other all kinds of cults, in the eyes of your God, Jewish Ashkafa, like Rav Avigdor Miller Zatzal. It's a great guide for life. Do it. Nobody stops you. The Torah is right here. Grab it. Don't let it accumulate dust. It was given. You have kosher books. Grab them. You have still few kosher speakers left in the world. Stick to them, but only to them. Only. Do not waste time on all this modern, rotten, horrible ideology, all kinds of stupid missionaries. Stay away from this kind. Be very careful. There's few diamonds out there and a lot of cubic zirconia. Be careful not to put your money on the wrong one.